this morning feeling fine. I woke up with heaven on my mind. I woke up with joy in my soul, 'cause I knew my Lord had control. Well, I knew I was walking in the light, 'cause I've been on my knees in the night, and I prayed till the Lord gave a sign, and now I'm feeling mighty fine. Well, I'm feeling mighty fine. Yes, I'm feeling fine.
I got heaven on my mind.
We want you to go with us now through an exciting journey of gospel music by a household name in the ministry of gospel song. Many, many years this quartet has traveled the nation. Hundreds of thousands of people have heard the good news of Jesus. Their life has been changed. They've made a difference. And you know, nobody can duplicate the sound of this group. They're one in a million. With the anointing of the Holy Spirit. If you love them, let's give a big welcome to the Cathedral Quartet.
Thank God for his leading. Thank God for his guidance.
Come on.
And thank God for this particular time that we're going to share with you people tonight. We're so thrilled to be here. And I feel like that we are on holy ground tonight, because I believe God wanted the Cathedral Quartet right here tonight. Nowhere else in the world did God want the Cathedrals, but right here on this platform with you people tonight. So we're thrilled for his leading and his guidance. I pray. Boys, it feels good, don't it?
Oh, man.
You know, I looked around at Glenn here, and I just happened to think, me and Glenn was finishing getting dressed on the bus out there a minute ago. Glenn's been out here 46 years traveling I've been out here 44 years, and after the young guys had got dressed, me and Glenn was finishing getting dressed. And Glenn bent over to untie his shoes to put his boots on, and he stayed bent over, and he stayed bent over. Finally, I said, "What is it, Glenn?" He said, "I just trying to think if there's anything else I need to do while I'm down here." Oh, I love old people. I really do. Nowadays, Glenn just sits in his rocking chair. He can't get it to going.
Sure.
You know, nobody knows how. Only thing we know about Glenn's age is when Glenn was a little boy, the Dead Sea was just sick back then.
Sure.
Boys, I'm on a roll tonight, and I'm doing it. We're thrilled to be here. Hey, you know what? I wasn't through singing that song. Let's do it in that last verse of On Holy Ground.
Yeah, I feel like I'm on holy ground tonight.
Moses stood for 40 years upon God's word. Talked to God so many times this he'd never heard. When God spoke from the burning bush, saying it's the Lord you found. So take your shoes off, you're standing on holy ground.
I'm standing on holy ground.
With perfect peace and everlasting joy I'm found. With his glory all around.
In God's presence, I'm standing on holy ground. I'm standing on holy ground.
My sins have been blotted out, and the Word of God says He blotted them out and never to be remembered again.
Amen.
And I don't know why I was talking about Glenn just then. Let me tell you something. I mean this from the bottom of my heart. Glenn and I have been traveling together for the last 25 years. We've been walking on the stage somewhere about the United States or Canada. Together for the last 25 years. We've been out here longer than that,
yeah.
But God has allowed us to work together for the last 25 years. I've heard the old man sing a lot of songs. And this...
He can't get away from that old man, can he?
No.
I was just thinking about what your brother... I'm going to share this.
Now, you shared enough already.
What's he going
to... I turned around and looked at Glenn and... Just thinking about how ugly he was now. No.
Sure.
No, I was talking to his brother, and I was talking to his brother about that, and his brother said, if you thought he was, you know, some women have morning sickness before the baby's born.
Right.
They said Glenn was so ugly, his mother had morning sickness after Glenn was born.
Sure.
Glenn, he didn't say that. I made that up here. I want you to listen to the old man sing a song that talks about your sin as being as far as the east is from the west. Now, I get a little bit excited on this song. I'm liable to run a little bit.
Well, don't do that.
I want you to listen as he sings, in the depths of the sea.
Man has climbed every mountain, no matter how high. He has conquered the planets from sky to sky. But there is
the stains. I'm free from the bondage.
Come on.
Free from the chains. My sins are separated.
Come on.
As darkness from dawn.
Claim the word of God tonight that my yesterdays have been blotted out and my name is in the Lamb's Book of Life. You know what? We can tell how long a program we want to do after we sing our first couple. So a lot of times we want to leave after we sing our first couple. Tonight we'll sing a little bit longer than what we would normally. You folks are out there. Yeah. This, sir. There's a little boy came around. Where's that? Maybe this, I can't tell. Maybe, but he came up to me, 5, 6 years old. He said, "Sing me a song." I said, "What do you want to hear?" He said, "Do This Old House." I said, "You got it, buddy." I started to walk away. He said, "Wait a minute." I went back. He said, "Do it the third song." I went back and I said, "How come you want me to do it the third song?" He said, "I may go to sleep."
We got one right here, George.
We got one here on the stage that might go to sleep on us. You know, this song does mean a little bit more to Glenn and I than it ever has. This Old House, Stuart Hamlin wrote the song. Read a little piece in a paper a few weeks ago. Maybe you did, too. Stuart Hamlin passed away several weeks ago, 80 years old. And one of the greatest songwriters. And old Stuart was a real cowboy. And Glenn, it means a lot to Glenn and I, this song, and Stuart's songwriting, because years and years ago, Glenn and I had the opportunity to travel around even this part of the country with Stuart back in the old days when we went in cars. We'd get in the car, leave somewhere like Akron, Ohio, drive up into Pennsylvania, up in here, do a program, and then ride back that same night. And Stuart Hamlin would share different stories with us, the way he came about writing this song or that song. We got just a minute. Let me tell you this. Stuart said that him and John Wayne were hunting up in, I think it was Montana. Way back in the hills. Seen an old cabin, an old house. The door was kind of standing open. And he said he was kind of scared to go in. He took his foot and kicked the door open a little bit. He said the skinniest old dog run right between his legs, and he said he liked to die right then, because at the first he didn't know it was a dog. So the dog circled him a couple of times, wagging his tail. He thought, what in the world is an old dog doing in this old cabin? And he went in a little further, and there laid the master, the dog's master, with his hand off the cot, and he had passed away. The body was kind of decomposed, and the old dog went back to the head of that bunk, laid down, wagged his tail at Stuart. And Stuart said, John Wayne was standing behind him, said, Stuart, that'd make a real good song. And he said, that's the way this song was born. Yeah, and it kind of, I can kind of relate to this. It said, one verse said, this old house is getting shaky. This old house is getting old. This old house lets in the rain. This old house lets in the cold. But my hunting days are over. I ain't gonna hunt the coon no more. Gabriel done brought in the chariot.
Yeah, come on.
When the wind blew down the door. You know what? I can kind of relate to that song. I realize, and Glenn, we've talked about it. We got a lot more singing days behind us than we have ahead of us.
That's for sure.
And we realize that. But we're having the time of our life right now, doing what we believe God called us to do. Do this old house.
This old house once knew my children. This old house once knew my wife. This old house was home and comfort as we fought the storms of life. This old house once rang with laughter. This old house heard many shouts. Now she trembles in the darkness when the night wind walks about. Ain't gonna need this house no longer. Ain't gonna need this house no more.
Ain't got time to fix the shingles. Ain't got time to fix the floor. Ain't got time to oil the hinges nor to mend the window pane. Ain't gonna need this house no longer. I'm getting ready.
This old house is getting shaky. This old house is getting low. This old house lets in the rain, and this old house lets in the cold. On my knees I'm getting chilly, but I feel no fear of pain, cause I see an angel peeking through a broken window pane. Ain't I gonna need this house no longer. Ain't I gonna need this house no more.
Ain't got time to fix the shingles. Ain't got time to fix the floor. Ain't got time to oil the hinges nor to mend the window pane. Ain't I gonna need this house no longer. I'm getting ready to meet the
now my old hound dog lies asleeping. He don't know I'm gonna leave. Else he'd wake up by the fireplace and he'd sit there and howl and grieve. But my hunting days are over. I ain't gonna hunt the coon no more. Gabriel done brought in the chariot when the wind blew down the door. Ain't gonna need this house no longer. Ain't gonna need this house no more.
Ain't got time to fix the shingles. Ain't got time to fix the floor. Ain't got time to oil the hinges nor to mend the window pane. Ain't gonna need this house no longer. Ain't gonna need this house no longer.
Line of that song says, I'm getting ready to meet the saints.
Yeah.
Praise God, should Jesus come tonight, I'm packed and ready to go.
Amen.
Got my house all in order, and it's well with my soul.
Amen.
Well, praise God. Feels good in here, ladies and gentlemen. You know what? Let me do something that we don't normally do right now, but...
I hope we know it.
We better.
Glenn and I went to Stamps Baxter School of Music down in Dallas, Texas, many years ago.
1905.
Bless his heart, his mind comes and goes. But we went there to learn how to read the shape notes and to sing this style of music. And somebody asked us to do a song from one of our albums that we did in London with the London Philharmonic Orchestra. In fact, we recorded an album with the London Harmonic Orchestra in London. But we did a song on there, a cappella. Our record company said, don't do all the songs with the orchestra. It may be a little bit boring to do them all. So we was thinking about something to do different. Glenn come up with this, to pick out an old Stamps Baxter song. Usually when you do something a cappella, you'd pick out an old hymn or something at least that's slow that you know. But Glenn picked this one out. The syncopation and the afterbeats in this song here is just unreal. I'm going to turn my back to you so I can look these guys in the eyeball here. Now, Glenn, this was the style of song that my daddy used to bring me to hear you sing when I was a little bitty boy.
Thou shalt not lie.
I used to sit on the front row in a pair of knickers and watch you sing, Glenn. Give us the key to that heavenly parade there, Roger.
Our traveling days will soon be over here, and we should cross the rolling tide. For we're down here for just a little while, our home's on the other side. Ambassadors true for Jesus our Redeemer, and it is a love's crusade. For right against the wrong, but soon we'll join the throng in the heaven when the saints parade. For heaven King, for heaven King, we'll let him sing the story. The story's story, 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 that Jesus can redeem your soul from every known sin and make it pure with joy. Billows know you then will roll. A happy new song you will begin to sing to Jesus, either way hath made. To glory and prayer we'll have a mansion there and join us in the saints' parade. For heaven, we would gladly sing the story. The sweet story,
I asked Glenn, I said, is that the way you promenade? He said, I don't know, that's the way I do it.
Yeah.
Oh, bless you. Are you glad to see Roger Bennett tonight, ladies and gentlemen?
Roger!
I want you to listen to Roger do something called A Perfect Heart.
Thank you.
Mark Trammell, we introduced some people from Arkansas. Let me introduce another young man from Arkansas. Mark has been with us for 9 years, the Cathedral Quartet.
Longest 9 years I ever spent.
You know what? Before I introduce Mark, every time I look around at Glenn, I happen to think about something.
Well, look around somewhere else. Don't look around.
Let me share this with you. Glenn lives kind of out in the country. We went by to pick him up just before we left on this trip, and Glenn was out in his yard waiting on the bus to get there. Well, Glenn lives on a little country road. I'm going to tell it. And there's a guy turned on the road just in front of the bus in a sports car. Well, the road's small. Once you get on Glenn's street, you don't turn around for a while, you know. Well, he kept looking behind and saw the bus behind him. He knew he couldn't back up, and he knew he was on the wrong road. And we live about 30 miles from Cleveland, Ohio. And so when he passed Glen Street, he realized it was one of the places to turn around. So he stopped when he saw Glenn up in the yard. He didn't bother to pull in Glenn's drive. He just leaned across, rolled down the window, hollered up at Glenn in the yard and said, "Hey, buddy, how do you get to Cleveland from here?" And Glenn hunkered down, hollered back, and said, "Well, my son usually takes me." That ain't got a thing to do with this song. I just thought you all know that. I want you to listen to Mark Trammell sing a song. Mark can take a song like this and magnify the name of the Lord like nobody else I've ever heard. This has got a little country flavor to it. And talking about country, we was in Nashville, Tennessee a few months ago, and where they have the Singing News Fan Awards in Nashville every year. You probably watched them on television where they vote for the favorite this and that and the other. Just to... Not long ago, old Mark Trammell was voted the favorite baritone singer all across the country.
Right.
I love the title of this song. It says, "He saw not what I was, but praise God, he saw what I could be."
Side of a place called nowhere, forgotten by humanity. When they talked about potential, they did not refer to me, 'cause everyone could clearly see what I was at all. So now you know the reason I lift my hands so willingly.
Yes.
If he hadn't found me when he did, I'd still be lost as lost could be. Although I'm still far perfect. I'm even further still, you see, from the life I lived just yesterday,
yeah,
before the Lord found me.
If I can, you know, I love the Lord tonight with all of my heart. I thought for 15 years I had him inside of my heart.
Come on.
Folks, all I did was play church. I'm a Baptist preacher's kid from Arkansas, and I knew how. I grew up in church, so I knew how to play all the games, do everything. You know, the deacons walk by and pat the little cute preacher's kid on the head and keep going. I knew how to play all the games. I've done everything from teach Sunday school to direct singing in my dad's church. But you know what? I didn't have Jesus in my heart. I had him in my head.
Yeah.
I knew all about him,
yeah,
but I didn't know him. And if you don't know him tonight, you're living way beneath the greatest privilege that you'll ever have as a human being, and that's to know Jesus. Yeah. And if you love him tonight, I want you to help me give him a great big hand right,
yeah,
now, okay? Praise the Lord.
You know, I cry a little easier than I ever have in my life now. I guess I'm just a little more sentimental. Maybe life means a little more to me. I don't know what, but I just cry easier than ever. I can read the Yaller pages and cry nowadays. You know?
I caught him in a phone booth today just crying his heart out.
And there's another thing about me, when I cry, I also snot along with it, and I can't help that either.
I don't believe I said
well,
that.
Well, that's the way. I've seen some people cry and their nose be dry as a bone. But I don't know. I get a bubble from the first tear, you know. I don't know how I got into that. Let me sing a song for you that means so much to me. I heard Bill and Gloria Gaither do this song before I had regained my strength and before I had actually regained my voice. And I said, if God ever lets me sing again, I want to sing this song. And if I can get through it, let me sing a song for you that means so much to me. The song says, "That's What Jesus Means to Me." Thank the Lord.
You can take all my possessions, all the things that men hold dear, all the precious gifts that this old world can hold. But listen to this. But the love I found at Calvary far exceeds my fondest dreams. this world's gold. Then you ask me why I love him, why I choose to walk this way. Well, I find his service sweeter every day. It's the only life worth living. He has made our home complete. Then each night, round sundown, my girls all gather round. When the clouds of gloom and doubt would hover low, listen, and then whisper, "Dad, we really do love you." And my doubts just seem so small. He's made our home a heaven here below. Then you ask me why I love him, why I choose to walk this way. Thank you for allowing me to do a song that means so much to me. Boy, the Lord really knew just where to send the Cathedrals today and tonight, boys. The Lord really knew where to send us, right here to Faith City.
Beautiful.
And I thank God for his prayer. You know, we travel so much and 250 some dates a year we do, and 150 to 175,000 miles in that old bus out there. A lot of places we go, people come in, sit down, fold their arms, and say, "Bless me if you can." Better than you have tried. Boy, it feels good in here tonight. Right. We were somewhere the other night. About 3,500 people. Where was we, though?
It's L.A.
L.A.
Lower Alabama.
Probably was. But we went in, and they looked at us like they was afraid we was going to steal their hubcaps, you know.
I got me a pretty nice set.
Bless his heart. When he wakes up, whatever's on his mind, he just blurts it out, you know. You know, while we were doing songs with the soundtrack, Danny Funderburk, would you do something for me? In a moment. In a moment, we'll do some things that Danny just really raises a roof on, but while we're doing songs, we don't do a lot of songs with soundtrack. Maybe this particular night we'll do more than we normally would because of what we're doing. But I want you to listen to Danny do something. We did this in London. Most tenor singers are concerned with how high they can sing and raising the roof. And Danny can do that better than anybody in the world. But he can also do this. Take a song and sing it with such heart and feeling. The way he ends this song just flabbergasts me. This is a little different than anything you'd hear most tenor singers do. Listen as Danny sings a song called For What Earthly Reason.
He was a giver. And his only reason was me.
Things that Glenn and I are asked as we travel about the country, I guess it's because of our age and maybe because of what I've been through, and they ask you, how you feeling? And me and Glenn always say, oh, we're feeling mighty fine. And right. Not long ago, old Glenn run across a song that's been laying around for ages. Mosey Lister wrote the song.
Good song.
The title of the song says, I'm feeling mighty fine. Let us sing it for you now.
Well, I woke up this morning feeling fine. I woke up with heaven on my mind. I woke up with joy in my soul, 'cause I knew my Lord had control. Well, I knew I was walking in the light, 'cause I've been on my knees in the night. And I prayed till the Lord gave a sign, and now I'm feeling mighty fine.
Feeling mighty fine,
yes, I'm feeling fine.
I got heaven on my mind.
On my mind.
Yeah. walking with Jesus all the time. We're walking and talking as we climb. We're traveling a road to the sky, where I know I live when I die. He's been telling me all about that land, and he tells me that everything is grand. And he says that a home will be mine. And now I'm feeling mighty fine.
Well, I'm feeling mighty fine.
Feeling mighty fine.
Yes, I'm feeling fine.
I got heaven on my mind.
On my mind.
Don't you know
I want to go?
I want to go.
Yes, I want to go.
Mark recorded a song on an album called Going in Style, and an old boy named Harold McWhirter down in Tallapoosa, Georgia, wrote this song. First time I ever heard the song, first time we heard it. I looked around the boys after we heard the song. We was all standing there, tears running down our cheeks.
Yeah.
Let me quote the chorus to you. It says, sin will take you farther than you want to go. Slowly but wholly, taking control. And sin will leave you longer than you want to stay.
That's right.
And sin will cost you far more than you want to pay. I was in the 82nd Airborne Division, Fort Bragg, North Carolina. I got with the wrong crowd. A little boy called Mousy Gonzalez introduced me to marijuana. A little later on, I nearly wound up in the gutter because of the bottle. You know, when Mousy, and I was from the hills of North Carolina, I'd heard about marijuana, 1950. I'd never seen a marijuana cigarette. Mousy introduced me to one. I thought, I'm away from home and family. I'm going to try one of them cigarettes. 1950, I'll never forget it. I tried one. 1950, 51, 52. 53, I was smoking them left-handed cigarettes, thought I was the toughest paratrooper to ever walk.
Come on, come on.
Sin will take you farther than you want to go.
That's right.
Sin will leave you longer than you want to stay. And because of sin, I nearly lost everything that was dear to me. Sin will cost you far more than you want to pay. But one day I came to the Master, fell upon my knees, and cried out for mercy.
Glory, glory.
And in mercy and love, he opened his arms, and he welcomed me home.
Amen. Glory.
Listen to Mark sing a song that says, sin will take you farther than you want to go.
Sing to me, boy.
Sing a song.
As a child, I foolishly turned God away, not knowing the heartbreak a sinner must face. But God in his goodness has led
pleasure and promises. Sin took control, leaving me dying with nothing to show. Gone were my loved ones, oh, yeah, and my dearest friends. Only a Savior, yeah, could love me again.
Sin will take you farther than you want to go. Slowly but wholly taking control. Sin will leave you longer than you want to stay. Sin will cost you far more than you want to pay. Oh, sin will take you farther than you want to go. Slowly but wholly taking control. Sin will leave you longer than you want to stay. Sin will cost you far more than you want to pay.
I've heard a lot of songs written about the blood. This song here, I believe, is one of the most unique songs I've ever tried to help sing in all my life. In fact, I tell you what, I'll have to use the book because I don't know it. And another thing, if I use the book, I'll have to use my glasses. Hand me my glasses over there, Roger. Now, this is something we don't normally do.
Somebody hold mine down on the front row, I could read.
This is something we don't normally do, and people saying, well, you guys are cutting the video. You mean you're going to do something like that? And, well, you know what? We could come in here and we could rehearse for days, and we could make everything look so professional.
Come on.
But you know what? If the Holy Spirit don't come along and lead and guide and direct, it ain't going to mean nothing no how.
Amen.
It ain't going to mean nothing no how if the Holy Spirit don't come by.
Glory.
In fact, let me quote you the verse that I'm going to sing.
I love it.
It says, through the ages, it has never dried, though the spring it came from died. For the spring, listen to this, for the spring reborn now intercedes for me, and the crimson river sets me free. Gonna sing you a song about the blood, ladies and gentlemen.
There's a river flowing deep and wide, coming from the Savior's side. From his hands, his feet, and brought sweet holy time.
die for the spring reborn now in her seeds for me.
And the Crimson River sets me free.
Crimson
Danny, we've been letting Danny loaf for a while. Danny, on the third verse, when you sing your third verse tonight, sometimes you don't hit the high note on this song. Tonight, you hit that high note or I'm going to hit you. No, I want you to listen to probably the most powerful tenor singer to ever come along in the gospel music field, Mr. Danny Funderburk.
I can see the hand.
When I look at the moon, stars in the sky,
I can see the hand of the Father.
In the valley so deep, the river so wide,
I can see the hand of the Father.
I can see the hand.
Touch of God.
In the music of birds, in the rustle of leaves,
I can hear the voice of the Father.
In the thundering rain and whispering breeze,
I can hear the voice of the Father.
I can see the hand. Hear the voice
blowing in the wind. I can feel the mighty touch of the Father's love.
Everywhere I go,
everywhere I go, His presence surrounds me.
I can see the hand, I can hear the voice, I can feel the touch of God.
presence here tonight, don't you?
Yeah. On a warm summer day when the sun's shining bright, I can feel the touch of the Father in the snow that falls on the cold winter's night. I can feel the touch of the Father.
See the hand, hear the voice, I can feel the touch. See the hand, hear the voice, I can feel the touch.
See the hand, hear the voice, I can feel the touch. I can see the hand, hear the voice, feel the touch.
Summer day when the sun's shining bright, I can feel the touch of the Father in the snow that falls on the cold winter's night. I can feel the touch of the Father.
I can feel the touch. See the hand, hear the voice. I can feel the touch.
I can see the hand, hear the voice. I can feel the touch. I can see the hand, hear the voice, feel the touch. But God.
Most of the time after featuring Danny on a song like that, we would give him a break and feature somebody else. But they say when you got a good horse, ride him. Here's a brand new song that says, when I met Jesus, I just started living. I just started living.
Danny's
singing,
or
I'm gonna slap you good.
If I had hope only in this world below, I'd be covered with troubles, and there'd be no place to go. But when I'm in Jesus, it's so.
Yeah.
are getting lighter, my days are getting brighter, I just started living. Oh, my loads are getting lighter, my days are getting brighter, I just started living.
Oh, yeah,
I just started.
Now, how many times have you walked through this old world and somebody point a finger at you and call you a fanatic? Well, it happens to us quite a bit, but let me tell you something. I don't mind that one bit, because when Jesus saved me, I just started living.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, don't you look at me funny.
Oh,
you old prophet of doom. You said one bit discouraged.
Do this with me. Ain't nobody here but us and the Lord. Do this. What can wash away my sins? Nothing but the blood of Jesus. What can make me whole again? Nothing but the blood of Jesus. Oh,
what can